Welcome to another tutorial on how to use the Las Cumbres Observatory robotic telescopes. In this video, you'll learn how to schedule observations on our new and improved observing interface, and how to access the images and data once your observations are complete. Make sure you have your Las Cumbres Observatory account details ready, and let's get started. The first thing you need to do is open your web browser and go to observe.lco.global. Log in using the top right button if you haven't already. This is your observing homepage. Here, you'll see some of the previous observation requests you've made. To submit a new request, click Submit Observations on the right, or from the menu bar. This page contains a form that will provide details of the observation you wish to carry out. Let's start at the top. The title acts as a personal reference, so choose a name that you'll remember easily in the future. I'm going to call mine Demo Observation. For most of us, we'll probably only have one proposal, so don't worry too much about that, but just select the one that's in the box. Okay, now we're going to get to the interesting stuff. We need to select the telescope class and instrument. At the time I'm recording this, Las Cumbres Observatory consists of a network of 18 telescopes, including two 2-meter class telescopes, 9 1-meter telescopes, and 7 40-centimeter telescopes. The class you choose really depends on the object you want to observe. For large, relatively nearby objects, such as the famous Messier objects, you'll need a large field of view, which the 40-centimeter telescopes provide. For more distant objects that appear smaller and fainter, the 2-meter class telescopes are more suitable. Once you've chosen an instrument, the next step is to enter your observation target. If you're new to observing or need some inspiration, take a look at our Messier Bingo Tombola. As well as being a fun game, this provides a selection of the most stunning night sky objects, including nebulae, galaxies, and star clusters. You can also browse our image archive for ideas. You'll find links to both on screen and in the description below. Once you've selected a target and entered the name, you'll notice the next two fields are automatically filled in. These are the object's coordinates in the sky. So that's done. Now let's look at the filters. These can appear intimidating, but you're likely only to want to use the Bessel filters. These include a blue filter, Bessel B, a green filter, Bessel V, and a red filter, Bessel R. If you're using the 0.4-meter telescopes, you'll have to use the SDSS R prime filter instead. To make a full colour image, you'll need one observation from each of these three filters. If you want to experiment, try adding an H-alpha or an H-beta filter, or perhaps an O3. How many observations do you want with this filter? Enter the amount into the exposure count field. I only want one, so I'll leave it as it is. The next field is the exposure time. This is how long the telescope will look at your object for. The fainter the object, the longer your exposure time will need to be. Make sure you enter the exposure time in seconds. The maximum length is 300 seconds, which is exactly 5 minutes. You can duplicate this section by clicking here on this icon, which will allow you to take several observations of the same target using different filters or perhaps different exposure times. Finally, enter the period during which you'd like your observation to take place. If you're unsure when your target will be visible, you'll find a link to our visibility calculator here. An exposure time calculator can also be found on that page, and several other useful things are available in the planning tools section, which is linked in the page header. Click Submit and then Confirm. Your observations have now been sent to our robotic scheduler, and will be booked onto a suitable telescope based on your specifications. Now we're back to the homepage. You'll see your observation request at the top here. You can also see its status on the right. When your observation is completed, there will be a 1 in the rightmost column. You can set up notifications, so you receive an email when your observation is completed. To do this, click on your username and go to Profile. Select Notification on Authored Only. Be aware that if you select Notifications Enable, you'll receive an email each time anybody on your proposal or project completes an observation. Save your settings and return to the homepage. Now we'll look at how to access your images. As you can see, several of my previous requests have been completed. To select this one, I simply click on the title. You can see my image on the right. Next to that is a download button. Press this and your image will be downloaded directly onto your computer. And there you have it. We've carried out an observing session with the Las Cumbres Observatory Robotic Telescope Network and downloaded our data. If you want to know how to turn your black and white observations into spectacular full-color photographs using software that's available for free on the internet, click on the video on screen now. And if you're curious about who we are and why we've built these robotic telescopes, check out our FAQ section. I hope you found this video useful. See you next time.